Hi, explorers. I was trying to stream a game the other day, and I was thinking that it would be nice to display some status information about how many people are viewing, how many followers do my channel have, what kind of what time is it, and so on, and I knew that there were services that could do this for you, and I'm using XSplit to record, so I thought that there should be a plugin to do this, and I looked around at the plugin calendar and didn't find anything, and then I ran across this service online that could make custom overlays for you, and they said that you could just do this custom overlay at their site and then put an URL into XSplit broadcasts. And it just worked. So in Broadcaster, where you create your scenes, there is actually an options that you can add other and a web URL. And that web URL could be used as an overlay over your game. So when I looked at this and I was trying to figure out how good this overlay was and how often it was actually updated, I tried to implement a small JavaScript because we are developers, so how hard could it be? So I implemented a JavaScript that updated the time every 100 milliseconds. And that just worked. So that got me curious, how hard could it be to implement the Twitch stream information into my actual application. So when I looked at this, it was wasn't that hard either, actually. So this is the layout that I came up with. I just use some colors. I show the followers, the viewers, my current FPS that Twitch is actually telling me that I have, and the time. And I have laid out them in the corners of the screen, so I can have my camera in the bottom corner. And to do this, you just create a web page with no background and the actual text that you want to display. So let's look at the code. Go over to my editor here. And then I just created this simple HTML document, and I put in some font. So I tried to use Roboto. I thought that that might look better on screen. I might try another font later on. Then I just set the body to use the Roboto font. I put the font weight to slightly bold. I use a font size of 1.4 rem. Rem is actually used so you get device independent size of pixels. Might not be that interesting or might not be that required if you're doing a stream, because that will scale with the video size, but yeah, it could be good to know that these are device accurate. So if you put something in a rem, then you will get the same size on every device. And I set the height to 99 view height. And that's because if I put 100, the web browser inside of the broadcaster software of XSplit didn't show 100 height. It actually is a little bit smaller. I think they have a border or something like that. We might actually change this to just have the margin 0 and body or padding 0, and that might have solved my issue too. I don't know. And then I put the right column to be 99 view height as well. I display that as flex, put a column layout, and made some space between so it will look nice. And that will actually make if I say flex and have an height and column, then I will get this left side column. So I could actually put in a few elements and they will be displayed all the way through this column. So I could get, if I have four elements, they will be distributed all the way through this column. And then I just said that I wanted border box, so I could put some padding inside of it, because if you don't have any boxes sizing, I think the default is that the margin, the padding, and the border in some web browsers are included in the actual width and height. And that's not what I wanted. I wanted just the width and height to be calculated from the actual... the padding should be inside of the box. So that's what I'm doing here. Then I put some color values here just for my text and my spans. The spans is the actual numbers I show, and the divs are the things around them showing... the header information. And then I have this height span that will push the text in the bottom and the in the top on either side, and I say that that should have a flex of 12. And in flexbox you are actually dividing your flex area into 12 equally sized spaces. So if I say flex 12, then I will take all the spaces to this height span, and that's what I want, because I want to push my content outside of this height span as far up as possible and as far down as possible. And if you look at my setup here, I have the right column, I have the two showing in the top, and those are pushed up by this height span here. And then we have the two in the bottom, they are pushed down by the height span. So that's why I have flex 12 on that one. And then we have my my little JavaScript here. And it's just, I wanted to put it in frame, but I can't. So it's just a set interval, I have a date, I have inner HTML, and then I just, format my date so I will show it correctly. If we push this one down to a few rows here, you see that I actually removed the seconds by a substring afterwards. I thought that there should be a variable that you could say that your time string shouldn't have seconds, but I didn't find one, and I were in a hurry to get into the game, so I didn't put it in there. I wanted 24-hour clocks, and I wanted it in Swedish time format, because that's more readable for me. Then I get the stream information from my stream, the weird named, and I use Fetch, which is an API that is quite new, but I thought that it should be available in the Xtreme, and it actually was, so that's good. And when I run this here, I get the response back in a function, so then I just... in this response value I have over here, I get the content header, and this is an example that I actually found online. So it will check if the content type is of JSON. Otherwise, it will just set the values to once. So then I know that if I get a misformed document back, then I just put out once. And if I'm not streaming, the stream object will be null. And I wanted to show that followers, viewers, and FPS to be -2 when not streaming, so I can see that it actually works then as well. And I will have a different error for not receiving any data to if you're not streaming, you didn't get this specific data. So I wanted to have different error codes there. So that's, if you look back at the here, I see I have my minus 2 on each of these. So I see that I'm not streaming at the moment. And when I'm streaming, I'll get a document where I can see stream channel followers and stream viewers and average FPS. So let's see here. Let's see if I can put that up fast here. Let's see. Twitch API stream. So let's see here. Stream first. Nope. Just so we can see how this document will look. Streams. There we have it. Just so you get a feel for this document. So it could be quite extensive. You have the in the streams object, you have the viewer count, you also have the game playing and the delay if you want to print that out, when the stream was created. And then in channel information, you have a lot of information here as well. And I just used followers. And I could put in views as well, but I don't really see any point of that. And then you have a lot of links that you can use. So I think that the data that I get back is very verbose for the things that I wanted to use it for. And see here, I also use the FPS counter. I don't see it here, but it's actually also transmitted in this document. So that's my little overlay that I built here. It's not much, so much to it. The interval that I'm using is every 5 seconds. And this kind of data isn't updating that often, so I think that 5 seconds should suffice. And I'm not a designer, so I haven't put any real design into this. I just wanted to display some status information. If you have more of a design skill in your background, you can do a nice overlay with nice graphics and so on. There's nothing hindering you from using different graphical elements, but I think this little tutorial should get you going on building a simple and nice usable overlay for your gameplay. So if you thought that this was interesting content, and if you have any comments, please leave them below. If you have built your own and want to compare, please give me a link to your Git repository. I will put this up on my Git repository, Kalasbuffer, probably name it Overlay or something. And any other comments? I'm reading all of them and answering all of them. So I'm looking forward to talk to you soon. See ya!